Hi, this is Brian with Prophetless Media and Post, and today I wanted to talk about adding supervised or user trackers to the 3D camera tracker inside DaVinci Resolve Fusion. Now, by default, the camera tracker doesn't have the option to add supervised or user tracks. There's a workaround that we can use, which is to alter the footage so that hopefully we can trick the camera tracker into tracking specific locations. Now, if you don't need the actual locations for the 3D camera solve, you can always use a 3D locator after you have a solve to find specific locations. And I have a tutorial on how you can use a 3D locator with a camera solve, which I'll put the link up right now. And you can check that out if that's what you're looking for. Let's add in a camera tracker. So let's turn on the preview. Okay, and so we have all these tracking markers here, but if I specifically needed a tracking marker here, here, and here to set up my coordinate system, now I could go here and change the feature size and add a whole bunch of trackers, and eventually maybe I'll get what I need. Instead, we can use the regular tracker and then add a mask, basically make tracking locations that maybe we can trick the camera tracker into tracking. So let's add a tracker. I'm going to turn that preview off. Let's add a regular tracker. And let's connect that up. And we'll look at the tracker. And we need three trackers. So I'm going to add two more. And let's just line these up with the three locations that we want. Okay, once we have them lined up, let's just track through our scene. Great, and it looks like we have decent trackers. And so now we're going to add in our mask. So we're going to use an ellipse. And you can use whatever you want to be your tracking marker, but I'm just going to use this for an example. And then I'm going to grab a background so that we're going to have these little black dots that we're hopefully going to trick the camera tracker with. And the way we can set up each one of these trackers, we're going to use a transform for each one. So we're going to grab three transforms and then merge that over our footage. That's our camera tracker. Now, obviously, we need to make this ellipse a lot smaller. So you may need to change the size of the ellipse depending on what you need and or even the color depending on your footage. But for this footage in particular, the ellipse and the black background seem to work out pretty well. So now that we have our dot, let's move them into position. So let's go to transform one, and under the center, let's connect to tracker path one position. And the same for two. Let's go to transform 2, path position 2, and then transform 3, it'll be the third position, path 3, position. Okay, and now if we look at our footage, we can see that we have our three dots. So now let's turn on the camera tracker and see what we get for preview. Okay, great. So now this worked out pretty well, that the dots are the tracking marker, looks like they're definitely right in the center. If they don't end up in the center, then you may have to change the scale of the ellipse to make it work out so that it tracks exactly where you want it to. But you know, this is a decent workaround. Okay, so now that we have that done, let's turn off our preview and let's hit auto track. Okay, and then let's go over to the solver and solve. Okay, great. So now we have a solve, but you can see that one of our trackers has actually got a high error. It's red. But let's see if we can fix that, because we know that that tracking is nice and solid from our tracker. So let's use our tracking filter to select all of them, and we're going to deselect the tracker that we had. So command drag, we'll deselect that, and then we're going to delete all of the rest of the bad trackers. And let's solve again and see what happens. Okay, great. Now our tracker is nice and green, and we have an error value of 0.36, which is actually quite good. Now we can go over to our 3D scene transform, and set up our coordinate system based on our supervised tracks. So I have, let's use this one as the origin. And then let's shift select the other two points and use that for our ground. And then let's go back to aligned and then export. And now we can see, put up the 3D merge. So now you can see that we have our coordinate system set up based on our supervised tracks. So this is one way that you can add supervised tracks to your 3D camera tracker to trick the camera tracker into tracking specific locations. I hope you've enjoyed this tutorial, and I'll see you again in the next video.